Welcome to part two of our server preferences videos. In this video, I will take you through the compliance and warnings tab in our server preferences. So once you have opened your server preferences, we can go to this tab and we can apply here our compliance checks and validations. So you'll want to check this box right here so that we will actually apply anything that we're actually activating right now. And what we can do is now set those fields. So if we want to have a customer profile required when a certain amount of money is being transacted, we can do that right here. So let's say we want to set that at 1,000. I'm dealing with US dollars here, so $1,000. Every time someone comes in and they want to make a transaction over $1,000, the system's going to require a customer profile to be made for that person that's come in. Then we can also set the same for a large cash transaction limit threshold. So that, for example, anything over $10,000, there's going to be a limit threshold set there. You can also apply a limit for requiring a social security or any other kind of unique serial identifier here. And again, set another limit for requiring additional documentation. For example, a PP we can put in here. Now onto our checklist. So we can apply check customers against OFAC sanction list. This is highly recommended. This is our US sanction list, and it's the most accurate and it's updated on a daily basis, so we'll want to do that. Then we can also activate up to 7 other watch lists. Countries included in this are such as Canada, New Zealand, UK and Australia. We can also have a warning set up. So if a custom profile is incomplete, and it's highly recommended to do so if you want to be compliant with Know Your Customer. We can also warn if repeat transactions for a same customer are happening. So if, say, a customer is coming in every 2 to 3 days making very large transactions, you might want to have a warning coming up for that particular person. You can set the days that you want to do that over here. So for example, we can just put 2 days in here. We can also have it set so that the system automatically checks customers before every invoice, which is also recommended. We can request a review of the customer profile after a certain amount of days as well. So right now it's set for 2 months, but you can put any kind of range in that. So say you wanted to do a somewhat yearly check of all your customer profiles, we can put those amount of days in right here. We can also apply an override password. So if you don't want every single user dealing with large transactions, we can set that limit. So let's put in $10,000 here, and then it would require a manager or someone to come up with the override password so they can't be doing the transaction by themselves for these amounts. We also can set a maximum allowance for rate change. You don't want some employees perhaps putting in, by accident, a very large percentage range, or maybe not by accident. So you can set a limit right here. So we can keep that at 35%, which is pretty high, so that they can't go any higher than that. Force users to register the customers when dealing with a check or wire. That's definitely something you want to do so you have record of that, rather than just any walking customer dealing with a check. Warn users when cash balance is negative. Again, you don't want amounts to be sold of currencies that you don't actually have. So this will give a warning that their cash balance is negative in that certain currency. We can also select the warning tolerance level. It's very highly recommended to keep that at the normal mode, where the warnings can be ignored, but the warnings are still coming up. The relaxed mode is going to turn off all your warnings, so you won't see any of these pop up. And then, of course, you can put the severe mode on, where the warnings will come up, but they cannot be ignored, so then everything needs to be applied before you can move forward with that transaction. Once you have set these, we can now save the settings, and they'll be applied to your server preferences.